Welcome to Punarvasi Technologies. www.punarvasi.com is my website where I use blogging software for writing different articles on SAP basis administration. In this video, for continuation of my earlier video, that is installing ACC 6.0 EHP 6 IDES. This is the final screen you will get once the all the pages are completed successfully. So that is execution of enhancement package 6 for SAP ERP 6.0, SAP application server ABAP, Oracle central system has completed. Click OK and the main screen will be closed. So that's all about installing of ACC 6.0 EHP 6 IDES software. I'll show you how to do post installation task. That means how to install SAP GUI software and then how to log on to the SAP system, then how to configure transport management system, and then how to activate developer access. All these activities I'll show you in this video. Just I am connecting to my server operating system, that is Windows Server 2008, where we have installed Windows ACC 6.0 EHP 6 IDES software. So this is the system, and once the ACC 6.0 software is installed, you can start it by using SAP Management Console. So under SAP systems, you should be able to find out the related SID which we have specified while installation of ACC 6.0, that is E6D is the SID. You can find out the work process information from this. So it should be in the green color, then you can consider that it is SAP system is completely started. Okay, now you can start the installation of SAP GUI for Windows software. Just you need to have the software in your computer to start the installation of SAP GUI software. It is copied into the E drive and it is located in the dump folder. Windows and Win32 and double click on setup all icon. Click on the next button and select all, click on the next, click on the next, click on the next. It will take some time for completion. Okay, SAP front-end installer. The installation of SAP front-end components completed successfully. Click on the close button, and by this time it is SAP logon icon also has been created on the desktop. You can use that icon for logon to the SAP system. Just double click on this SAP logon icon so that the SAP NetUI, SAP GUI for Windows will be started. And here under connections, connection section, nothing is there. Just you have to create the connection by right clicking here. Click on the add new entry. Click on the next button here, and you can provide any type of description like this: ECC 6.0 EHP 6 IDAS. So this same software, same SAP GUI, SAP logon program will be used for connecting different SAP systems. Application server is what? The server name of the server. Server means computer name of this particular server. That is ECC EHP 6. And the instance number is 00. Here if you are able to see, this 0 means you have to provide 00. The instance number will be incremented by 1 if you start installation of another SAP system software in this particular same host machine. It will give you the 01 instance number here, and system ID is E60. Click on the finish button. So once the entry has been created, just you can use this particular entry for log on to the SAP system. Just double click on it. This is called SAP initial screen. Welcome to the IDES ECC 6.0 EHP 6. And that by default the client is 001. You can change this particular client to 800 like this, and the default user is ID admin, and the password is IDES. Hit enter. You can make this client as default client by setting some parameters. I'll show you how to do that. Just the license expires on 29/7/2014. That means it will work for 3 months time from now. Click continue. Okay, this is the SAP Easy Access screen. From here you can execute different types of functions in the SAP system. And as post installation tasks, you have to check for the installation errors. That is SICK is the command. SICK means it will check the installation errors, and it should give you this information, this message, that is no errors reported. And next thing is, and you just check it up the components of the SAP system. Just go to status, and EHP 6 for SAP ERP 6.0. And the database is Oracle, release is 7.2.0.3.0, and the database SID is E6D, host is ECC EHP6. And from here you can click on this button for component information. It will show what all the components are installed in the system. That is, you see the SAP basis release is 731 and patch level is 0002. Okay, and the ABAP component also release is 731 and level is 0002. That is, patch level is 0002 and PI basis, that is basis plugin, and PI SAP solution tools plugin, and SAP BW, SAP business warehouse. When you install SAP native or software, you will have these five components, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 components, and remaining all the components are of ECC system. Means there are lot of components available. Just to see different HR components and lot of components are installed here. So it is actually main ERP system, that is ERP central component. And that's all. Just close this, and you can also find out the kernel information from here. Just click on the kernel info, and kernel release is 720 and support package level is 100, and it will show the IP address of this host machine, that is 192.168.2.8. And the DAB release is this. Okay, and click on the continue button and continue. You have to configure transport management system once the SAP ECC software is installed and logged in. To configure TMS, you have to log on to the system as 000 client. You can't configure TMS in 800 client. That's why you have to log on to the system using 000 and 000 and the default user DDIC, and another default user called SAP star also will be there, and the password of the DDIC is the password which you have installed, which you have provided while installation, that is master password, and same password will be used for SAP star also. And once you get SAP easy access screen, you have to type SE06T code here. And you have to specify what type of installation it is, that is SAP created by standard installation or database copy or database migration. It is a standard installation. We have not copied database. We have not used the method database copy or database migration for this SAP system creation. So that first option you select and click on the perform post installation actions. And do you want to reinstall the CTS, change and transport system, single system settings, set yes. And processing after installation completed, configure TMS. Now you are ready to configure the TMS. How to configure the TMS? What is the T code? STMS is the T code for configuring TMS. Just enter the STMS and hit enter so that the TMS will be configured. And the TMS profile file will be stored in this particular location, that is C drive, user folder, SAP, trans, and bin directory. So the configuration of the TMS will be stored in this particular directory. So first, as soon as you enter STMS T code and hit enter, you will get this particular screen. From here, whatever the system name has been provided here, and description, and transport domain is name domain underscore E6D, description is transport domain E6D. Accept the defaults and click on the save button here to complete the configuration of TMS. And you have to provide the password, same master password you provide, hit enter. You are logged on to the domain controller. So that means it is successfully configured. Transport management system is successfully configured. You can click on the overview and click on the systems to find out the systems which are configured in this particular domain. How many systems are configured? Only one system. One SAP system is configured. Means it is single system landscape. So that's all. This is only one system is available in this particular domain. Now the next step for post installation task is you have to set the default client. How to set the default client? Just use the RZ10T code for changing the parameter. And first time you have to import all the profiles of active servers. Go back and profile is so I have clearly explained about configuring these parameters in other videos, other SAP basis administration videos. So just in this particular video, I'm just selecting the required profile here. Just default profile, double click on it. And click on extended maintenance and click on the change button. And the default client, that is login slash system underscore client is 001, it should be changed to 800. Double click on it and type 800. Yeah, just click on the copy button here. Changes were made and go back and click on the copy button again here. The changed profile was transferred and go back and click on the save button here. Incorrect parameter values detected, display values, click on the no. Do you want to activate the profile? Click on the yes. And profile version is 11, saved and activated. Click on the continue button. The effect of activating a profile is simply that the profile is stored at operating system level, see administration data. For the profile to take effect for a particular application server, you have to restart the application server. So you have to restart the application server. Just log off from the system. And restarting means just close this and right click, click on the stop, click OK. Just I was talking about this transport domain, that is TMS profile in USR folder, SAP folder, trans directory, bin folder. So these are the file configuration files about transport management system. I have closed this window, that's why I opened again, and these are the files. And I have stopped this. I have to wait until it turns the color to gray. Once it is stopped, you have to start it right click, start it by right clicking and click on the start button. Click OK. Click on refresh so that it will take some time and it will be restarted. It will be started. You have to get all wait in the status column and yes in the start column. Click on refresh. Okay, it is started. Now double click on this. You see the default client became 800, means every time there is no need to change the client from 001 to 800. Directly you can log on to this system using id admin.
and the password is IDES. This is the default user which is provided for IDaaS systems.
So next thing is that you have to activate the developer access in this, and to activate the developer access, just type SE38 gcode. So just try to create some program like this, z_raz_sample_program. Click on the create button. Type sample program here and select the type as executable program and click on the save button. So click on the local object. So this is the ABAP editor. From here you can write your own program. Just I am writing a sample program here. Write is the keyword. Just welcome to SAP NetWeaver training. Put the period, that is full stop, and click on the save button and check the syntax check. That is, sorry, it is activating the program. Before activating the program, you have to check the program code for errors. So if any syntax errors are there, it will show you the errors. Okay, and once it is done, just click on the activate. Once the active object generated, just click on the direct processing to execute this particular program. So the program name is z_raz_sample, and the program output is this: welcome to SAP NetWeaver training. So in this way you can access the ABAP editor for writing ABAP program, so that ABAPers can use this particular platform for creating their own programs. And other functional consultants can use their related menus, that is under logistics, different modules will be there, and under accounting, different modules will be there. So according to their module they can work with, that is materials management, sales and distribution, logistics execution, production, production process, plant maintenance, customer service, quality management, like that. And under accounting also there are a lot of modules are available, financial accounting, financial supply chain management, like that. And under human resources, so these are all the modules are available. And if you look at SAP NetWeaver system, basically you will not have these many modules. The SAP NetWeaver system only can be used for ABAP programming and basis administration and BW, that is business warehousing. Okay, and that's all. And what else? And if you have connected with the SAP Solution Manager, and if you have official router configuration with SAP support, you can use SPAM for applying patches. SPAM is for applying patches, and SAINT is for installing add-ons. SPAM and signed. So this is the maintenance certificate. Maintenance certificate is required for applying any patches. So just click on the continue button. This maintenance certificate also can be obtained from the SAP Service Marketplace. And you see the support package and display package level, you can check from here status. And what are all the components are installed in this machine, in this SAP system, and along with the patch level, it will show you here. So you see the SAP basis is 731 is the release, software component release, and it is SAP level. That is, patch level is 0002. Like that, all the components will have their related release and patch level. Okay, and also if you want to install some add-ons, you can use SAINT Saint T code. SAINT Saint. And this also require maintenance certificate. Once the maintenance certificate is available, it will not give you that message. And here these are all the components already added. And if you want to add another new component, you have to click on the start button, and then you have to show the add-on file, like a source file, that is installation file, that should be extracted to the trans directory. Inside the trans directory, I have shown you trans directory. Inside the trans directory, apart from bins, there is another folder called EPS, so electronic parcel service. Under EPS, you have to put the files inside EPS indirect. So here you have to put. Okay. So in that way, you have to configure all the post installation steps. I hope you understood the different tasks has to be performed after completion of the installation. I hope you understood this particular experiment perfectly. Just log off from this system. And if you want to stop the entire system from here, that is, stop it and click on the OK. And so data should not be, yeah, it should be here. Accidentally data went inside the EPS folder earlier. Just close here. Once it is stopped, I'll shut down the server operating system. Before shutting down the server operating system, just I want to show you one more service here. Services dot msc. Just remember that always the service called Oracle TNS listener should be started, that is, Oracle TNS server TNS listener service should be started. Yes, it is in manual. You have to make it as automatic, so that every time there is no need to come here. Automatically the service will be started when the server is started. Just close it and close this. And once it becomes a gray color, I'll shut it down. Just I'm making it as small screen so that you will understand I'm doing this particular installation within the VMware. So this is the VMware system. This is my another system, that is Windows 7 operating system. Inside Windows 7 operating system, this is Windows server operating system. You can also install a GUI program in this Windows 7 to access this particular SAP system from your like laptop. Or if you have another computer in your network, from that computer also you can access this particular ECC software, ECC system, using SAP GUI for Windows. So it is stopping. It stopped almost. Just you have to wait until the color turns to green. See, it became gray green color. And there is no need to stop this DAA, diagnostics agent. just close this. No, start, shut down, hardware maintenance, click OK. So you have to wait until this black screen goes, then you can consider that this particular VMware workstation has been successfully shut down, and you should not be able to, you should not see this green arrow mark, that is like this it should show. That means it is completely switched off. Now if you want to switch it on again, just you have to click on the power on this virtual machine so that the system will be started, that is Windows Server 2008 will be started, so that you can start SAP system using that SAP management console, and right click on the SID, that is E6D, and click on the start button, provide the administrator password, so until within 2 to 3 minutes the SAP system will be started. Once it is started, you have to use SAP logon program for log on to the SAP system. So that's all. Okay, if you have any doubts on this particular experiment, you can leave your comments in my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, or you can use the YouTube comments form also, leave your messages. And if you like my videos, you can subscribe to my channel using this punarvasi.com website, under punarvasi.com. Just go to SAP basis videos. SAP basis videos. I have listed all the videos which I have recorded as of now here, along with the time duration. So this is the time duration. You see, I have recorded 87 videos, and this video will become 88th video. And you can use this subscribe button for subscribing to my private channel. That is $179. I am offering subscription price, that is Indian rupees, in Indian rupees 9,999 rupees. And all the best. Okay, and you will also get my email support for your questions. If you have any questions and doubts, you just send me a message using contact us page, or also you can use this below comments form for leaving your questions. Thank you very much for watching this video.